CPI, Italian test, remote task B, attendance IT 11235.
Hello? Hello?
Hello, interpreter?
Yes.
Hello, interpreter?
Yes, sir, good morning.
Yep, this is the interpreting agency. So we have a telephone interpreting job here. Dr. Brown from the hospital's emergency department is with an Italian-speaking patient. Are you available to do this job?
Yes, I am.
Okay, so I'm now connecting you to the doctor and the patient. Dr. Brown, I have the interpreter here. Please go ahead.
Hello, interpreter.
Good morning, Dr. Brown.
Hello, yes, I'm Dr. Brown. Interpreter, I've got a patient with me, a Mr. Gerardo Tropico, and I need to speak with him about his health condition. First, I'd just like to confirm that you are an Italian interpreter?
That's correct. I'm an Italian interpreter. My name is Sara.
Wonderful. Look, please, would you like to go ahead and introduce yourself to Mr. Gerardo Tropico?
Buongiorno, signor Tropico. Mi chiamo Sara e sono la sua interprete per oggi.
Salve, interprete.
Interpreter, you don't need to interpret what I say next. All right, I'd just like you to interpret what we say to each other. If you need us to repeat or to clarify something, please just say so. Also, if one of us talks for too long, just ask us to pause so that you can interpret. Okay, let's start. Well, okay, good afternoon. I'm Dr. Brown. I'm on duty here at the emergency department at hospital. I need to make sure that you are aware that you are in hospital.
Buon pomeriggio, sono il dottor Brown, sono il medico di turno al pronto soccorso e voglio assicurarmi che lei sia consapevole di dov'è che è in ospedale.
Sì, ma non capisco perché sono ancora qui, perché mi sento bene.
Yes, but I don't understand why I feel fine.
Yes, I understand you may feel fine. I recommend that you stay in hospital a few more days, observation, some tests. Now,
I'm sorry, Dr. Brown, to interrupt you, but the line was disturbed. I couldn't understand. Would you mind repeating what you just said?
Oh, certainly. Now, I understand that you may feel fine, but the paramedics and doctors observed some symptoms. You're unable to move the right side of your body. You're having difficulty speaking. And you're generally a little confused. Now, I recommend that you stay in hospital for a few more days for some observation and some tests. Now, Mr. Tropico, do you know what happened?
Sì, capisco che lei possa sentirsi bene adesso, ma i paramedici e i dottori hanno osservato alcuni sintomi. Non è in grado di muovere la parte destra del suo corpo, non è in grado di parlare, è in generale un po' confuso. Le suggerisco di rimanere qualche giorno in più in ospedale per osservazione, per test, per esami. Signor Tropico, sa che cos'è successo?
Ho avuto un mancamento e al momento sono in vacanza in Australia con mia moglie e avevamo un tour organizzato con circa 11 persone. Dopo la prima colazione il pullman ci è passato a prendere e niente, avevamo in programma di visitare località turistiche, ma purtroppo sull'autobus faceva molto caldo, l'aria condizionata non funzionava e l'autobus in genere era scadente.
I had a dizzy spell. Now I'm on holiday in Australia with my wife. We are on an organized tour with 11 people. After breakfast, the bus picked us up and we were planning to do some sightseeing. But on the bus it was really hot, the air conditioning wasn't working and the bus was lousy.
Well, now, I'm really sorry, but I need to go now. I will ask the nurse to book an appointment for you for more tests and I will look at the results when they come in.
Mi dispiace, ma devo andare adesso. Chiederò all'infermiera di prenotare un appuntamento per ulteriori esami e controllerò i risultati una volta pronti.
Grazie, dottore. Allora ci penserò su.
Thank you, doctor. I will think about it.
Thank you, interpreter.
Thank you. Grazie, signor Tropico. Arrivederci.
Grazie.
Bye.
remote task B is now complete.